get through. I can't get through. Got me chasing you.
What's up, guys? Your boy Chase back with another video.
I know I've been absent for some time. I think maybe a week or two. Anyway, your boy
is back. That's all that matters.
Anyway, guys, today I'm doing a Q&A, the first one of the channel. Is it? Yeah, it's the first one of the channel, guys. So thank you for coming. So, you know, my Q&A. I did like a question thing on Instagram. I'm gonna do them all. I might do like a part two. So, cause I'm trying to make this video as short as possible, cause I got a lot of videos I do want to post for you guys. Just comment down below what you'd like to see next. And yeah, ask a couple questions on Instagram, like I said, guys. So first question is from the user Shup. Shout out my boy Chris. This question is from him. How have sneakers impacted you when it comes to style? Let me see, that's a good question. They've impacted me coming to style, because it's like, look, I got this bummy North Face gray hoodie on. I got some black Nike sweatpants. If I throw the right pair of shoes with it, the whole outfit comes together. Shoes helped me, like when I was younger, I used to flip them when I didn't have a job. So that helped me in a tremendous way, because you know, no one really hires a 15-year-old anywhere. It's kind of hard unless you want to work at McDonald's. But if you do work at McDonald's, I'm not knocking. I'm just saying, like, it's kind of hard to get an actual real, like, decent job at the age of 15, guys. Sneakers have really impacted my life. I made a lot of money from them, from reselling. I don't know, like, even though the sneakers do sit in my closet, I actually do kind of just like looking at them. They bring like a little like pizzazz when I walk past my closet, realizing like my clothes isn't up to par with my sneakers. I used to get so upset when I was a kid when I couldn't get the newest sneakers. Like, I don't know, this is like brainwashes you guys to get like more sneakers, and it's like, you're not gonna wear them. I have like five, you know, matter of fact, I have 7 pair of Vans that I haven't even opened yet, just because it's like I just wanted to have them at the time and I just got bored, you know. Next question, it comes from Sierra Style. Shout out Sierra, make sure you go subscribe to her channel, guys. Why did you start YouTube? That is a good question. I did a video maybe 2 years ago, 2017. I started YouTube because it's like a bigger platform. I used to do Instagram skits. I used to do like funny videos on Twitter and everything. My high school knew me for doing the videos that I did, like the little short skits, because Instagram back then didn't have a full minute thing. They would let you do, I think, like 30 seconds. So I would do that. And I was like, yo, let me take it to YouTube. I've always had a YouTube account maybe since, I'm going way back. If you count like my old accounts, I've had a YouTube account since like 2009, but I didn't use it to the best of my advantage. And if I did, boy, would I still be in New Jersey? Probably not. But I started YouTube, you know, to make more people happy. Like, there's it feels really good when people you don't know from out of country, out of state, comments or just DMs you on social media and just tells you like, look, bro, you made my day. I don't know who you are. It's always the people that you don't know that show the most love than the people that you're close to. The people that are close to you never want to actually see you win. I know it's kind of hard to believe, but if it's 2019, if you're not woke up now, well, then I guess you're just gonna be asleep, because if your friends don't want to see you win, then hey, should be your friends. But anyway, that was a really good question, Sierra. Like I said, make sure you guys go follow her, go subscribe to her account. She's a very good person and she does good hair, so yeah. Next question is, it's from Ilk. Shout out Ilk. I actually do remember messaging me on Instagram. She said she loved my videos. She was from Sweden. If you are watching this, comment down below. I honestly forgot where you were from. I'm sorry. I wish I can go back. I don't have social media right now. I deactivated it. So if you guys have been trying to look for me and search for me, I do not have it right now. I do have Snapchat. So do add me on Snapchat, guys. I appreciate that. But the question is, do you study at a university and how old are you? I do not study at a university. I do not currently go to school because I didn't go to school to do this YouTube thing.
What are you?
An idiot sandwich.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine. You're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
And I am currently 21. I just turned 21. My birthday, I can't even talk. I am 21 and my birthday's in August, so I'll be 22 this year. So yeah, another question from the same person, I'll answer, because I got a lot of questions, but a lot of them are basically like the same ones I've already answered. What are your favorite songs at the moment? I don't really go based on favorite songs or like favorite artists. Like, if I like a song, I like it. But I guess if I really had to pick, I guess I could pick Jaded by Drake and In Check by Bryson Tiller. Those two songs, like, I know they're very slow, but they just, like, I don't know, it just hits home, you know. If you know, you know. If you're a Drake fan, you know. If you're a Bryson Tiller fan, you know. Question is, this is from Official Toju. Make sure you go subscribe to my boy Toju. Link in the description below. Question is, what motivates you to keep going? That's probably one of the second best questions asked. Being motivated, man, is you know, God, music. Music is the number one thing. Like, the little message they put in there makes you like really believe, you know. It's like, I don't know, I just feel like that's why I make playlists. Like, sometimes when I'm going through bad days and I just put on the playlist and a certain song hits me, it makes me feel a lot better, you know what I mean? My family motivates me, even though like they don't really talk about like the YouTube videos I do and everything, but I know they support me. A message, like I said from earlier, this girl, she DM'd me, it brightened my day. It's like, you took the time, 2 seconds, even 5 minutes, 30 seconds out of your time to DM me saying you appreciate what I do, appreciate my videos, you know, that means a lot to me, you know, that motivates me, that makes me wanna keep going. I remember I first started off taking YouTube serious maybe like 2 years ago, maybe a year and some change, and I got frustrated, flustered, but when I think I went to Walmart one time, she was like, you're all HS, right? I'm like, yeah. And then she's like, I like your videos. And I was like, thank you, I really appreciate it. Even though I was fucking super awkward and shit. When I heard that shit obviously motivated me to keep going, because it's like, I love to have fans, but I also like to have people I can connect with, you know, because without you guys, I'm obviously nothing. And I get all nice messages from people I don't even know. People I see on my video comment consistently. I do appreciate that. The guys that actually do stick around, actually watch the whole video and see what I have to say. You guys do mean a lot to me and I appreciate it. Don't believe in myself, and that's why I guess like I take these long intervals during YouTube and everything. But I am back and I do believe in myself now, and that's all that matters. First ticket, this is by Shamar McKenzie. Shout out my boy Shamar. He means by like, obviously like, police ticket or everything, whatever, parking ticket, whatever. My first ticket was not stopping 3 seconds at a stop sign in a school zone. He pulled me over. This was like, if you guys do know about the quota that North Brunswick does, not even North Brunswick, just anybody, you know, when it's towards the end, when it's the end of the month, cops tend to pull over a lot of more people for stupid ass violations. He said I didn't stop a full 3 seconds. He said I was speeding and none of that was happening. When I asked him, can you tell me what I was doing wrong exactly, he just sped off. So that's how I know it was bullshit. But that was my first ticket, and ended up, I did not beat it in court, and I had to spend $500 for actually following the law. You know, North Brunswick, you fucking suck. But anyway, guys, this is my Q&A. I know it's kind of short because I have a lot of questions, but I just don't want to make a 20 to 25 minute video. Guys, I appreciate you coming back to the channel. Make sure you hit that red subscribe button if you're new to the kid. And like I said, make sure you sub to the people told you. Make sure you subscribe to Zero Styles. Those are two very good people and very positive people that I know. And like I said, comment down below what you'd like to see me do next. Follow me on Snapchat, and I will let you guys know when I reactivate my Instagram and my Twitter. But until then, it's your boy Jess, and I'll see you. That's not the end of the intro. This is
Something's got a hold on me. I can't let go. Out of fear, I won't be free. Something's got a hold on me. I can't let go. Out of fear, I won't.